Good evening. Just 2 weeks into the top job, Qantas's new CEO has delivered an extraordinary apology to the Australian public. Vanessa Hudson also today pleaded for patience and says the hard work required to restore the airline to its former glory has already begun.
The first public act as the first female CEO of Australia's national carrier, a sign of how far the flying kangaroo has fallen.
I know that we have let you down in many ways, and for that I am sorry.
A 90-second video mea culpa from Vanessa Hudson landed in the inboxes of Qantas customers at lunchtime, an attempt to show she gets it.
We understand why you're frustrated and why some of you have lost trust in us.
We spoke with the Qantas CEO this afternoon.
Are you a bit annoyed, though, that it's you having to give this apology and not Alan Joyce?
Look, I've just so proud of the organisation and listening to customers and listening to people. We're really focused on the future.
Let's be honest, though, Qantas's reputation is in the toilet at the moment. How are you going to fix it?
So I think that it's really important for me to recognise that we haven't delivered to what customers expect of us, and we've often been really hard to deal with. And that today I've really said sorry. I know customers have been frustrated. As well, I know some have lost trust with us. But what I am determined to do is determined to fix it.
Some of the changes outlined today, increasing the number of frequent flyer seats, boosting frontline and call centre staff, and making some procedures fairer, like not charging customers if they change the name on their ticket. As for whether we can expect lower prices...
Fares have come down and we believe that they are going to stay at that lower level.
But the airline's reputational damage is deep. There's an ACCC inquiry into claims Qantas sold tickets to flights that had already been cancelled. Mediation with unions over workers the High Court has found were sacked unlawfully. And the former CEO receiving millions in pay and bonuses.
Does Alan Joyce deserve to be walking away with the millions of dollars that he's walking away with?
I think that the board has made it pretty clear in the annual report that they are applying their governance and their discretion.
The new CEO has been with the company for 29 years and was part of the previous leadership team, choosing her words carefully when asked how she'll be different from her predecessor.
Having a leadership that listens, I think, is going to be the number one approach that I take that is going to be different moving forward.
Do you think companies in general need to get better at appointing women to leadership roles in good times?
Absolutely. I think it's, you know, women are amazing and I think there's no reason why they can't perform and step up equal to any other man.
It will be customers who judge whether she lives up to her promises. Jane Azzopardi, Nine News.